Good afternoon. My name is Amol Nergodkar. I'm the CEO of Patient Prism, and I'm delighted and honored to host Don Casey, the CEO of Dentsply Sirona, in our makeshift studios here at the Dykema Conference.
Oh, no, this isn't a makeshift. This is great. I'm really looking forward to it. First, thank you. I really appreciate the opportunity to talk to you.
Absolutely. And since you took over, we've seen nothing but great things happen at the organization. The stock price is all-time high, right? You have actually introduced innovation into a company that, into an industry that badly needed an aggressive guy pushing innovation. The technology that you guys are coming with are helping dental practices do a better job with their patients. And your focus on clinical education. I mean, I am like literally a student of how you guys do this. And so talk to us about your focus on innovation, new scanners that are coming out. Well, and how are they impacting practices?
Sure. Well, first, I coming from you guys calling us innovative, I almost feel like we're way, way low as you compared to total breakthrough things that you guys are doing. But
thank you.
Look, first, thank you for the nice words. I'll accept them on behalf of all of Dentsply Sirona because, look, I've got a great organization, and it's literally my pleasure to every single day to get up and work with 16,000 people around the world. And look, the innovation we've been coming up with, in my mind, is really a tribute to them. People who are focused every single day on how do we talk to dentists, how do we see what they're doing every day in practice, and how can we bring technology, equipment, consumables, new procedures, new thinking to them to help them really deliver better patient care. So the fact that we've got a little bit more innovation than we have in the past, we're excited about. Now, you bring up digital scanning. I'll tell you what, and this is a really interesting opportunity when we talk about AI and doing it one way, but in my mind, we finally have scanners that are so easy to use that they will be de facto become a standardized piece of equipment in a dentist's office. We did a thing when we introduced the POC mold, really cool. We had an 8-year-old and a 6-year-old. We had the 6-year-old teach the 8-year-old how to use our prime scan scanner.
Wow.
They did it and they were able to scan an upper and lower arch in under a minute. And what does that mean? It means, boy, the dentist isn't going to have to be the one that does the scanning.
Absolutely.
All of a sudden, we're going to have every patient scanned. And you think about the opportunity for data longitudinally to focus on a patient when they were 10, 15, 20. I think it's going to transform dentistry.
I mean, so now you're creating time for the dentist.
Right.
And you're making, obviously, the CEREC's been revolutionary in terms of getting more provider. I mean, provider availability is a big issue in the DSOs especially, right?
Right.
You need to be efficient. You need to be able to, people don't have time to come to you over and over again.
Exactly right.
And to get treatment they want. They want same day treatment for most things. And I'm delighted to hear about this longitudinal stuff because now having a consistent scan of your mouth and your teeth over a period of time is going to give us data that you never even had before.
Exactly right.
And I think that's going to also help in case acceptance because now it's objective, right? Now the machines and the data is telling you that this is what you need. It's not even my opinion.
Right.
That's fascinating. You focus a lot on clinical education of doctors.
Right.
Really enabling doctors to better clinicians. Why has been that a big approach to you guys?
Well, if you think about it, you know, a dentist will graduate school and, you know, they're going to do CE courses, but it's not necessarily a practical hands-on way of, oh, all of a sudden I have a 3D comb beam. I have a brand new digital scanner.
Right.
Hey, here's a new way to think about doing an endo procedure. They don't get hands-on training to do that. And we felt as we bring more and more sophisticated products and services into the market, we're going to have the responsibility to actually educate dentists on how to use it. So, you know, we really feel, look, if we can bring a dentist in and okay, this is what a digital scanner does. And it's not how to use the digital scanner so much as, okay, how can we change your practice? We really think we're going to ultimately help that dentist get more time.
Absolutely.
And, oh, by the way, deliver better patient care. So we really think it's a responsibility for what we're doing.
And you've got that fantastic center in North Carolina.
We do.
It's fully equipped to do all sorts of training. Is it clinical and non-clinical both?
It's really funny. people come in for the clinical training, and what they really realize is it's not necessarily the clinical training that they leave remembering. It's, you know, we talk about how to use this kind of equipment or this kind of procedure to talk to your patient.
Absolutely.
And, you know, look, I think dentists, by and large, do a fabulous job, and they're
Absolutely.
Delivering great patient care.
Absolutely.
But it's their ability to articulate, hey, why do I want to do a scaling and root planing procedure?
Sure.
That's a little bit harder. And all of a sudden, boy, we have a new piece of equipment. It's going to make it easier, faster, less painful.
Absolutely.
It gives the dentist a reason to go back in and have a conversation with the dentist, with the patient.
It's fantastic. I mean, I'm so delighted to hear the pace at which you're innovating is so incredible. And I think the whole industry is going towards that pace.
Yeah.
Because I think people have realized that dentistry does change people's lives. And it has such a big impact on overall health. And having the technology and the know-how to really impact patients' health while they're there is something that you guys are doing extremely well.
And it's important to us. I mean, look, you mentioned single-visit dentistry. I think that's a wave of the future. I think digital dentistry, that's a wave of the future.
Absolutely.
And look, ultimately, I think whether it's you guys helping out and helping dentists begin to understand how I can go back out and reach out to a patient
Absolutely.
Using sophisticated algorithms.
Absolutely.
Or it's us to say, hey, gee, you know, maybe we can't get everything done in a single visit today, but let's put out a plan over the next 3 years that can transform your oral health. I think that's going to be really important, because ultimately, if people have their oral health, they have their smile, they have their confidence, I think they live better lives.
Last question.
Sure.
Very important one. Sirona World this year, we know Jerry Seinfeld is almost there because the news is out.
Oh, that's a rumor. That's a rumor.
It's a rumor.
It's a rumor.
Seinfeld's my absolute favorite comedian of all time. I don't think anybody will top him, in my lifetime at least. But the entertainer. I mean, obviously, we've loved Katy Perry last year. We had
Imagine Dragons.
You put on the best show on earth. Period. Right. It's in Vegas nice. Again.
Mandalay
can
Bay.
Can I squeeze out the entertainer, or no? Is it not?
I would be happy to tell you, but then I'd have to kill you and your producer.
Okay.
You know,
well,
that's illegal in Dallas.
That's illegal in Dallas. That's right. Thank you so much for coming out to your studio
and
sharing some time with us.
Pleasure to meet you.
Pleasure, absolutely.
We'll see you in Las Vegas.
Oh, we are, absolutely.
Very good.